Ozone. Well, ozone is the naturally occurring O3 molecule that we know about, we hear about, that's in our atmosphere. The oxygen that we breathe, that our physiology naturally, you know, responds to, and our hemoglobin and our red blood cells picks up, is O2. One oxygen molecule bound to another one with a double bond, that's O2. Way up in our atmosphere, we have O3, three oxygen molecules bound together. Now, ozone inherently is a very unstable molecule. It doesn't like being in groups of three, it likes being in groups of two. So if you just take ozone gas all by itself, it will quickly break down into O2s rather than a bunch of O3s. Now, if you take that O3 molecule and introduce it into the physiology, its inherent instability means it's got lots of energy. And that energy, through a biochemical reaction, can be absorbed into the physiology, and miraculous things happen. Now, let me explain where this happens. Every cell in your body, right, has a nucleus where all the DNA is, and then around that it has the outside membrane. So you have the outside membrane and the inside nucleus with the membrane around it where all the DNA is. Inside that area, okay, between the two membranes, you also have little organelles, primarily mitochondria. You may have heard about mitochondria. They are the energy producer of the cell. They are the little engine of the cell. Inside the mitochondria is where the O2 molecules are processed. Okay, so the O2 molecules that you're breathing in, that are brought to the cells of the body through hemoglobin in your blood, they are processed inside the cell in mitochondria, where essentially the electrons off of those oxygen molecules are plucked off, and that energy is used to produce ATP. Okay, ATP is the chemical of the cell that is the gas, the fuel of the cell. Pretty much every cell in your body, no matter what its function is going to need ATP to do what it does. So if you're looking, for instance, at your pancreas and the cells in your pancreas that make insulin, the energy that those cells need to make insulin is going to be ATP. If you look at your muscles and the cells in your muscles that contract and give you all the strength to do exercise and whatnot, the energy of the cell to contract comes from ATP. In your brain, you know, in your whatever it is, anything the cell needs, okay, every function of the cell is powered by ATP. And that ATP is created inside the mitochondria by the mitochondria's ability to pluck electrons off of oxygen. All right, now what does that have to do with ozone? Anytime you have a tissue or a cell or an organ that's unhappy, that slowly but surely is becoming diseased, what you find out is that the mitochondria in those cells are becoming less and less capable of plucking those oxygens off, plucking those electrons off of the oxygen. The cells are becoming less able to functionally process the oxygen, and therefore they're become unable to produce ATP. When you introduce ozone into the cells, I don't want to get into all the details of how it does it, but the bottom line is it ramps up the mitochondria's ability to process oxygen once again. It's quite miraculous, actually. We know a lot about how it works, and it's fabulous. So not only can you energize cells to do what they're supposed to do with ozone, there are certain disease states you can actually reverse with ozone. So we use it as often as we can. And anyone really is a candidate for it, just to stay healthy and to boost your immune system and many other functions that you can do with regular ozone IVs.